We hear you, Colorado. You are independent thinkers. There are more independent voters registered in our state than Republicans or Democrats. So what does that say about Colorado politics and where you stand on the two traditional parties? Well, you may not know this, but Colorado has a new party. It's the Colorado chapter of the Working Families Party. And this is part of a national effort that says they are fighting for an economy that works for all of us and a democracy in which every voice matters. And Carlos Valverde of the Colorado Working Families Party is joining us now to talk more about this. This is a fairly new party in Colorado, but it's actually in 15 states and in D.C. So what is this party all about?
Sounds good. Yes. Thank you for having me on. The Colorado Working Families Party is a new progressive political party in Colorado. We are looking to build what we call an inclusive, multiracial populist movement. And I like to break those words down with some specific examples. When I talk about a populist movement, I think on the 2016 Bernie Sanders campaign around economic justice populism, and he was able to galvanize young folks and new voters in a very inspirational way. And when I talk about inclusiveness and racial justice, I look at the 2008 Obama campaign that galvanized folks from across our racial differences, across differences of all kinds, and ultimately won a Nobel Peace Prize for bringing people together. And so we believe that when we bring these two styles of campaigns together into one, that's where our party wins.
You're up against two machines. Do you see yourself as a third party, and how do you even become part of the conversation?
That's an excellent question. So while we are a third party, we're not like a traditional third party. Many folks describe us as sort of the Tea Party of the left. In the same way the Tea Party pulled Republicans to be more conservative, mm-hmm. we look to pull Democrats to be more progressive. While many of our values around, higher wages for people, affordable housing, universal health care are really similar to other left third parties, we sometimes believe that those parties, they run good values-based campaigns. Our motto is vote your values and win. And right now we think it's so important to win. In this era of Trump, it's important for us to win.
So how do you choose who you're supporting? There's yes. no one running as a Working Families Party member,
yeah.
right?
Yeah, so we traditionally endorse what we call Working Families Democrats. And so we have two ways of doing this. We look at seats that are really blue. These are Democratic seats. They're definitely going to win because we don't want to be a spoiler. So we look at those seats, for example, Senate District 34 here in Denver. That's going to be a Democratic seat. So we found the most progressive Democrat in that race, and we supported and endorsed that person.
In what way? Financially? Grassroots? What way do you do that?
That's a great question, too. So we're a new organization. We're only about 6 months old here in Colorado. So we're growing, but we're growing very, very quickly. And so our level of support varies depending on how we can raise money for these particular races. So from at very minimum, folks will get our endorsement, get that Working Families Democrat stamp of approval. This sort of demonstrates that this is the most progressive candidate on the ballot. Our organizing committee, that's sort of like our board of directors, are made up of labor groups, environmental groups, economic justice, LGBTQ rights groups, a whole cross-section of the progressive left in Colorado. So when you get our endorsement, you're really the most progressive candidate.
And those groups that you're talking about, do they feel like they've not had a voice to this point? Is that why the need for a third party?
Yeah, so those groups make up half of our coalition. The other half are individuals. And yeah, I think there are many folks, you've said the numbers just a moment ago, who feel that the Republican and the Democratic Party don't fully represent their values. And so we're filling that spot.
So you endorse candidates. What is it that you're trying to do? I mean, beyond trying to get someone elected, are you trying to change the conversation? What's behind this?
Absolutely. Like I said at the very beginning, we're trying to build a movement. And so traditional campaigns will hire a bunch of canvassers who will come in for that one campaign, knock on doors, make phone calls, and hopefully win their election. We're looking beyond just one election cycle. So instead of hiring a bunch of canvassers, we recruit volunteers. We have community organizers who go out into communities, engage people in political conversations to, pull politics to the left.
And at the national level, too, and at the state level. So, for example, you obviously align with Democrats. Does that mean you would support Jared Polis and Diane Primavera?
Yeah, so our committee will be now looking at the general election races, and that's one that we will consider. We do have a fairly rigid endorsement process, so we'll see how...
So that hasn't happened yet?
No, not for the gubernatorial race, but in other races, we have made several endorsements for the general election.
Very interesting. Okay, well, we look forward to hearing more about the Colorado Working Families Party.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Appreciate it. Back in a moment.